गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ दीपक शर्मा फ्रॉम आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पंप। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पंप। सो वी कैन ऑल्सो से द पॉजिटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट पंप। द पॉजिटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट पंप और रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पंप आर दोज पंप वेयर इन द लिक्विड इज सक्ड एंड देन इट इज एक्चुअली डिस्प्लेस्ड ड्यू टू द thrust exert on it by piston, thereby results in lifting the liquid to the required height. The reciprocating pump is a positive displacement pump. The conventional type of reciprocating pump is usually called a ram or plunger pump. Now we discuss about its classification. The reciprocating pump may be classified as follows. First, according to the action of water. There are two types of reciprocating pump according to the action of water. One is single acting pump and the second is double acting pump. Now the second classification is according to the number of cylinders. There are three types of pumps according to this type of classification. One is single cylinder pump, second is double cylinder pump and the third is three cylinder pump. Now the third one classification is based on the existence of air vessel. So according to this type of classification, there are two types of reciprocating pump, with air vessel and without air vessel. A reciprocating pump consists of a piston or plunger having a reciprocating motion inside a cylinder with the help of connecting rod or crank as shown in the figure number 1. The figure shows the complete parts and working of reciprocating pump, in which there is a suction pipe, delivery pipe, sump level, suction valve, delivery valve, cylinder, piston, piston rod, connecting rod, crank and the heads, delivery head and the suction head. Now we discuss about the working of reciprocating pump. The cylinder is connected to the suction and delivery pipe, each of which is provided with non-return valve. At the bottom end of the suction pipe, strainer is addition to foot valve is also provided. Suction pipe and clearance volume of the cylinder are first filled with water to replace air. This is known as priming of the pump. The foot valve allows the water to flow only in the upward direction in the suction pipe. The crank can be rotated either manually or by an electric motor. When the crank starts rotating from 0 to 180 degree, the piston moves outwards, creating a vacuum inside the cylinder and the atmospheric pressure acting on the free surface of the water in the sun. The water is sucked and pushed through valves. Water continues to enter the cylinder through suction pipe till piston reaches the outermost position, that is theta is equals to 180 degree. When the crank is rotating from 180 degree to 360 degree, the piston describes inward stroke and the water is pushed upwards in the delivery pipe to the reservoir. Volume or capacity delivered is constant regardless of pressure and is varied only by speed changes. Now we discuss about the single acting reciprocating pump. If water acts on one side of the piston, the pump is said to be single acting reciprocating pump. In a single acting reciprocating pump, water is sucked into the cylinder in the suction stroke and delivered out of the cylinder in the delivery stroke. The motion of the piston is not uniform and hence the discharge cannot be uniform. In the case of single acting reciprocating pump, the discharge will be zero during the suction stroke and at the start and end of the discharge stroke and maximum at particular instant during the discharge stroke. The discharge from the pump per second is given by the Q is equals to ALN divided by 60, where A is the cross-sectional area, L is the length and N is the RPM. Now, weight of water delivered per second is given by weight is equals to rho g q, where rho g q or rho g ALN divided by 60. Here we put the value of q which is equals to ALN divided by 60 as shown in the previous relation. The theoretical power required to drive the pump is given by the following equation, where HS is the suction head of the pump in meters, HD is the delivery head of the pump in meters, gamma is the specific weight of the liquid, A is the cross sectional area of the piston, and Q is the discharge of the liquid. Now we discuss about the double acting reciprocating pump. If water is pumped by both side of the piston, both suction and delivery, the delivery strokes takes place in suction and delivery takes place in every stroke. In every stroke, such pumps are called double acting reciprocating pumps. The discharge is usually taken to be double the discharge than that of a single acting pump. Reason for that is, in a double acting reciprocating pump, water is sucked on one side of the piston and delivered from the other side during the same stroke. This is the diagram of double acting reciprocating pump, in which there are two delivery valves and two suction valves, and there is a piston and cylinder, and connecting rod is one, and the figure shows the complete working of the double acting pump. Discharge from the pump is given by Q is equals to twice of the discharge of single acting pump, or Q is equals to twice ALN divided by 60. When neglecting the area of the piston rod, if we consider the area of the piston rod, then Q is equals to ALN divided by 60 plus A minus AP into LN divided by 60, where AP is the area of the piston rod. Power required to driving the double acting pump in kilowatt, which is equals to work done per second divided by 1000, or 2 rho g ALN into HS plus HD divided by 60,000. Thank you.